Hey guys, today I'm going to be showing you guys how to do contour and highlighting and what is the purpose of it, pretty much. First of all, I already did my foundation and my brows, obviously. Oh my god, I still have eyeliner on from last night. So first, I have a couple different contour palettes that you can use. The one that I normally use, my everyday palette to use for contouring, would be this one, the Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Kit, the light to medium one. I normally use this one right here. But before we do that, I'm gonna show you how to highlight and conceal. I use this Tarte Shape Tape for my concealing and my highlighting. This is what it's for, contour and conceal. Apply that, I just do dots. And you just want to do it under your eyes and then just do a little bit on your forehead. So for me, I have like more of a bigger forehead, so I'm not going to go all the way out here because the whole point of highlighting your forehead, well, the whole point of highlighting in general is to make things look bigger or make them pop. So under the eyes, we want to make them brighter. But for the forehead and like the nose and the chin, if you already have a really pointy chin, you're not gonna wanna put highlight on your chin unless you want your chin to look even bigger or longer. So me, I'd like to have it a little bit pointier. And I'm just gonna use a wet blending sponge. Before this dries, I want to explain it after, but I'm just going to blend that out before it dries. So if you have a big forehead, then you're gonna want to just put this like right here, like in between your eyebrows, kind of a little bit above, like just right in this little area. But you're not going to want to put it all the way out here because your forehead will look even bigger. If you have a big forehead, then you got to contour it. But if you have a small forehead, do not contour your forehead because it's going to look even smaller. You don't want that. You want to look like the typical face frame everybody wants. If you have a long nose, you're not going to want to highlight from here all the way down here. It's gonna make your nose look even longer, and you don't want that. Onto contouring. You can also use this Wet n Wild contouring palette. This one's cheap and it's really, really good. Like the powder's really, really nice. So I'm gonna get my brush, little pointy brush, and get some Laura Mercier translucent powder. I'm gonna put that under my eyes just to set it. Now you don't need to put that much, like unless you are a sweaty motherfucker. Just put it where you get oily most and where you want your concealer to stay. You don't need to cake it on like everybody does. I don't know why everybody does that. I'm gonna get my little brush. This is the Morphe Y10 brush. I'm gonna get this color right here. See where I have this dark, that contour already, the natural contour? So you're gonna wanna put it in that spot. It's probably like where your ear starts, like the top of your ear, and just go straight down. So that's where your contour would be. And you're not going to want to bring it all the way out to here because you're going to look weird. So just start up here. And then you can go down a little bit. But you don't want your face looking too long. So just contour right there. Circular motions. Same thing on the other side. Just right there. So for the forehead, please, for the love of God, do not contour your forehead if you have a small forehead. Girl, you're just gonna look weird. Stop doing everything that everybody else is doing, okay? It's just right here, since I have a widow's peak, I'm going to do my contour up here so that my face can just look oval. I want it to look oval. That's the typical face shape that you are trying to go for. So if this part of your face is protruding a lot, is coming out a lot, And you're gonna want to contour right here too. For me, it doesn't really do that, so I'm just gonna do up here. Just up there. Okay. And to be honest with you guys, you can contour down here, but I'm gonna tell you right now, in public, people can see that dark mark that you have right there. So if you want to do it really, really light, tap your brush, and then just slightly do it. Don't full on put like a ton of contour down there, because it's good for pictures, trust me, but like in public, people can see that. So I'm gonna get this brush. This is like just an angled brush. The BH Cosmetics 119 brush. I use this for my nose contour all the time. So I'm gonna take that same color and I'm going to just go in a little more, because my nose really just ends right here, but I'm gonna go in just a little bit because I want my nose to look thinner, look skinnier. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that on both sides. And because I want my nose to kind of go like this a little, like a little piggy, I'm gonna put contour down here and a little on the side so it can be pointier. Just like that. Like a little V. And a little on the top because I want my nose to be pointy, like a little button nose. So I'm gonna put that right there. See how it looks like way more button nose? I love that. I don't care if, you know, it looks weird on me or whatever. I think it's cute, so I'm gonna fucking do it. And you're gonna go all the way up to here under your brows. And I know I'm looking crazy right now, but I'm gonna go back with this Morphe Y10 brush that I use for my contour. I'm gonna wipe that off. I'm gonna use this banana powder right here. You can obviously see that I use it a lot. And I'm gonna go over what I just did on my nose so that I can soften it up so it's not looking too harsh. See? I like having a little button nose, so. Don't judge me. That, if you have a tiny nose already, don't contour your nose. If you want to, just to make your face look kind of symmetrical with contouring, then you can, you know, put the contour out a little bit more to make your nose look bigger, but people want thin noses, I guess, so. If you have a thin nose, if you have a small nose, just leave it. Just leave it alone. But other than that, that is how I highlight and contour. I think that's all the tips that I have. Bottom line, if put highlight where you want those areas to protrude, to come out more, to pop more, and contour what you want to hide away. So, that makes any sense? I hope so. I'm going to wipe off all of this translucent powder that I barely have on my face. Just a little bit. You don't need a lot unless you're really oily, and you do. And I'm going to take this Wet n Wild highlighting powder, and I'm going to put that on my cheekbones and on my nose. So yeah, that is how you contour and highlight, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you did, then subscribe. Okay, thank you guys so much for watching. Mwah.